Hello. When calibrating an array antenna, we are interested in the relative amplitude and phase differences between individual elements of the array. In this demonstration, we will use the SMW200NA to simulate different elements of one array antenna. For this, we can use the phase menu from the RF dropdown to set different phases in our SMW200A for the output. First, let's demonstrate that without a reference connection, we do not have a phase coherence from the generator to the receiver. And this is mostly the case for array calibration as well. So I will set up the SMW for a frequency of 3.5 gigahertz and activate a CW signal. On the FSW, we open the IQ analyzer, set the frequency to 3.5 gigahertz as well, and we show the IQ vector. Let's make an auto level and increase our data acquisition settings. So the sample rate we can reduce to 1 kilohertz, and with a little bit longer record length, we can see that the phase is rotating, since we do not have a phase coherence between the generator and the analyzer. So how can we differentiate between the phase of one element and its relative phase of another element? We can see that the phase is rotating, but we can try to correct the frequency error and the phase drift in post-processing. For this, we will use an automation software and go through the steps how an array antenna could actually be calibrated. Using the automation software, the SMW will be stimulated with different power levels and phase settings in a sequential fashion. This will simulate different elements being activated one after another, with an unknown, in this case random, amplitude and phase difference to the first element. When we start the execution, we can look on the FSW how the signal is being recorded. As the measurement is finished, we can see multiple circles. These represent the rotating phase at different amplitude levels as generated for the different simulated elements. In the software, we can see the recorded IQ data over time. The software automatically recognizes that we have switches between the elements as marked with red lines and will analyze only the green areas. This will leave a little bit of guard period to the switches. When we now correct the frequency error that is common for all elements, we can retrieve the original phases. Here we see the frequency error corrected results. Also, the IQ diagram now represents the actual phases as generated by the SMW. Here we can see the difference between the phases that are generated by the SMW and the ones that are retrieved after the correction of the common frequency error. As you can see, a high accuracy can be achieved using this method. This demonstration shows that even without phase coherence, we can still correct for the common frequency error when having different phases and amplitudes recorded for our array antenna calibration. The method can even be expanded with switching back to a reference element for correcting the phase drift over time. The same methodology can also be applied with different instruments, not only with any IQ recorder like the FSW, but also with something called the IQ versus slot option in our communication testers and production testers. Thanks for joining this demonstration.